Welcome to the next episode of Myeloma Made Simple, entitled Disparities in Myeloma Made Simple. Disparities in healthcare are defined as preventable differences in the burden of disease, injury, violence, or opportunity to achieve optimal health that are experienced by socially disadvantaged populations. This may sound like a complex definition, but sadly it is quite simple and obvious to see that there is a tremendous inequity in healthcare. This is particularly pertinent to myeloma, where the disparity may be the greatest of all cancers when it comes to the survival of African American patients with myeloma. Indeed, the statistics are quite disturbing in that survival of African American patients is roughly half that of white patients with multiple myeloma. This is further complicated by the fact that myeloma is twice as common in the African American population. The nature of these disparities is quite complex and multifactorial, but I think it's important for us to spend a few moments to outline the scope of the problem and the IMF's response to it. Many factors contribute to health disparities that we see in multiple myeloma that include systemic racism, the social determinants of health, the healthcare system at large, insurance status within the healthcare system, mistrust in healthcare, as well as the delayed diagnosis and access to both diagnostic and therapeutic interventions. If we're going to see a greater health equity in this country, it will be necessary to address each of these categories in turn. It has taken hundreds of years to arrive at this degree of inequity, and it will take many systemic changes to reach health equity. We are committed at the IMF, both in the short term and the long term, to improve outcomes of all patients with myeloma, and in particular those who have had such an inferior outcome, such as African American patients and Hispanic patients. Here are some very myeloma-specific drivers of health disparities. Number one, health insurance. Several studies have validated the reality that African American and Hispanic patients are much more likely to be uninsured or on Medicaid when compared to white patients. This significantly affects the outcomes for these patients. Number two, socioeconomic status. A plethora of studies have demonstrated how socioeconomic status is proportional to overall health, but this has also been replicated very clearly in multiple myeloma, and it is critical that we address this issue. Number three, delayed diagnosis. It is well known that all patients with multiple myeloma are at risk for a delay in diagnosis, as there is no one simple sign or symptom that indicates multiple myeloma. A recent study has actually demonstrated that the average myeloma patient sees their primary care provider three times with signs and symptoms consistent with myeloma before the diagnosis is made. Actually, this is even prolonged in African American patients. The cause of this is multifold, including access to the healthcare system in general, as well as diagnostic testing needed for myeloma. Furthermore, the presence of confounding diagnoses such as diabetes that has so many overlapping signs and symptoms with myeloma may also be a cause for this disparity. This is one of the reasons why the IMF is so dedicated to educating the primary care world about both recognizing the signs and symptoms of myeloma and ensuring the correct tests are ordered to obtain the diagnosis. Number four, access. Indeed, this may well be the greatest of the disparities specific to myeloma. Several studies and real-world data have demonstrated access to nearly all myeloma treatments are reduced in minority populations. I often summarize them with the four T's that include triplets or three drug combinations, transplants or autologous stem cell transplantation, trials or clinical trials, and indeed most recently, CAR T-cell therapy, or this novel immune therapy that we can give to patients with multiple myeloma. This is by no means an exhaustive list, but helps us appreciate the magnitude of the challenge of disparities in multiple myeloma in obtaining the right diagnosis and providing the right treatment for our patients. I would add furthermore that suboptimal communication between patients and their healthcare providers is also a significant feature of the disparity. I have done research in this area where we recently demonstrated that there is a discordance between patients and their providers with respect to communication of goals and expectations of therapy. This discordance is not only between patients and providers, but actually differs between different races and ethnicities. Black patients, for example, are less likely to feel engaged in their myeloma care compared to white patients. As I've noted, the IMF is deeply committed to this issue and has created the M-Power program, which is dedicated to reducing the disparity through education and awareness within the community and partnership with medical and non-medical institutions to provide the education and support that these communities need. The word M-Power was designed to empower patients and communities to change the course of myeloma. In addition to this deep community engagement, we have launched an extensive educational program to primary care providers to enhance early and accurate diagnosis of myeloma, as well as hematology and oncology providers to provide culturally appropriate care and improve access and outcomes for patients. You can learn more about this at our website, mpower.myeloma.org.